In this video clips, I want to show the steps how to install Dynamics AX2012 Part 3. Just you go to your setup folders and here you will see the steps. Install Microsoft Dynamics AX components. Then you will see Welcome wizard for your Dynamics AX setup. Then click next. Add or modify components. To install Dynamics AX in your personal laptop, there are two ways to provide Dynamics AX facility in your laptop. First is you can create a virtual machine from any server where Dynamics AX is installed, and you can import that virtual machine into your laptop. But to use the virtual machine, you should have good RAM memory. It should at least 16 GB memory. If it is below that, then 12 GB is also okay, but 8 GB is lesser. It will work on 8 GB also, but major operation you cannot do. You need to set 4 GB for your virtual machine and 4 GB for your operating system. But a second way to install Dynamics AX in your laptop, you need a domain user login. In personal user or local system user, Dynamics AX you cannot install. And if it is Windows 2010, 64-bit, then it's better. In Windows 10, it's work faster. In Windows 8 or below version, Windows 7, it works very slow. So first you need to install Microsoft Windows 10, 64-bit. Then you need to put your machine into domain user and provide admin login to your domain region. Then you try to install Dynamics AX this way, which I am showing. Then you will be able to install Dynamics AX in personal laptop also. I have clicked here. This is a dynamic database node for Dynamics AX. This node you can install database. First you need to install the application object server. After installing this, you need to install Dynamics AX client. And if you have a developer license, you want to debug facility for Dynamics AX, then you can click on debugger option. Then Visual Studio tools you can install if you want to develop some SSH reports. .NET Business Connector is compulsory for installation of Dynamics AX. If you have already database to connect to Dynamics AX, then you don't need to connect to database. Then you can directly install AWS service and you can connect to the existing database. But if you don't have database, you are installing standard, then you first click the database and it will automatically create database for your application object server. If I click, as in the my system I am showing only the steps, so it's already installed. So I will click on next. Here it will check for your prerequisites. If you're installing the first time for Dynamics AX, then there will be a lot of warning and errors. And link has been provided. You need to download each link and install, complete your prerequisite first and remove the all errors and warning. Till the error zero, you cannot, you can install the Dynamics AX. Error number is zero. Warning, if it is warning, then it's okay. Here it's showing the database name, baseline database, With this, one database will automatically create like Microsoft Dynamics X underscore model, and its server name you can provide. You can next. Then you need to provide the instance name as a resource. Then just you need to click the next and finish the wizard. Then your AWS server will be installed. After that, you can install client X client. Then you can install debugger, Visual Studio Tools. A reporting extension is required to install for working properly for SSL report analysis service. After that, you can install analysis service configuration to work if you are using kubes and role centers. Enterprise portal, if you are using, then you can install. If you need to develop user control, you need to use role centers, then you need to install enterprise portal. These are the basic steps for installing the Dynamics AX. After installation, you need to complete the checklist. I found some steps to show you the checklist. I will show in my system. How checklist window will be there after installation. Just open your Dynamics X. Go to system administrator, go to checklist, initialize checklist. After installation of AWS and client, this all will be incomplete. You need to complete step by steps. If it is, you need to compile the application, you need to compile .NET into CIL. You need to provide license, if it is demo license, then you can provide demo license, then modify data type, synchronize data files. It will take a lot of time to compile the application, like it can take 3 hours, and synchronization will take half an hour. Then you have to provide, configure system account, initialize user profile, AIF and partitions. This checklist you need to complete after installation, then you can use Dynamics AX easily. Thanks for watching this clip. If you like the really this clip, then you can please subscribe it to my channels, as we are updating one clip daily to my channel, which mainly focus on ERP subjects and SQL database side. If you are a good learner, then you can learn from different channel on YouTube, different video already posted, lot of things you can search on YouTube and you can learn, as YouTube is in number one search for videos. You can get lot of videos from there. And as higher version Dynamics AX 365 is introduced by Microsoft, it's already in the market. I want to advise you also try to learn that things. Thank you very much for watching this clip. Thanks for watching.